The following question reads that which molecule has no overall dipole? And you're given four options. And if you look at all the options, it's basically just one carbon that is bonded to four atoms. Over here, carbon is bonded to three hydrogen atoms and one Cl atom. Over here, carbon is bonded to two hydrogen atoms and two Cl atoms and so on. Over here, carbon is bonded to one hydrogen atom and three Cl atoms. And over here, carbon is bonded to four Cl atoms. Now, to figure out whether the molecule has overall dipoles or not, I need to draw the shape of the molecules. And if you look, carbon is making four bonds. If it is making four bonds, the shape of the molecule is going to be tetrahedral. All the bonds are going to be as far away from each other as possible. So it's going to be, all of them are going to have a tetrahedral arrangement. So let me draw the three-dimensional shape of all the molecules first. So our four molecules are going to be tetrahedrally arranged. Let's focus on the first one first. So there are three hydrogens, so tetrahedral arrangement, carbon in the middle, three hydrogen atoms bonded to it, and on one side there's going to be a Cl atom bonded to it. Now, if you look at this molecule, the most electronegative element in this entire molecule is this chlorine atom. Chlorine are very electronegative, so all the electrons are going to be pushed closer or will be attracted closer to chlorine, which will give chlorine a partial negative charge. All the electrons, because it's the most electronegative element, so all the electrons would be lying closer to chlorine, and the rest of the molecule would have slight or partial positive charges because of the electrons being pulled closer to chlorine. So this first molecule is going to have a permanent dipole. And let's focus on the second one now, CH2Cl2. Let me draw the molecule. And if I draw the molecule, now I've drawn the molecule. In this molecule again, you have two hydrogens and two chlorines. So I've added two hydrogens and I've added two chlorines. And again, chlorine is more electronegative. So if you look at the shape, all the electrons are going to be dragged closer to chlorine. So since chlorines are not on opposite sides of each other, so the electrons overall in this molecule would be attracted closer to the two chlorines that are bonded to this carbon atom. So these chlorines will have a partial negative charge, whereas the other two hydrogens would have a partial positive charge because their electrons would be closer to chlorine. Let's move to this third molecule now, where you have only one hydrogen and you have three chlorines. And again, if you notice, all the three chlorines are pulling the electrons downwards. This chlorine is pulling electrons towards this. This chlorine is attracting electrons towards you. This chlorine is going into the page. But overall, the effect would be all the three chlorines would be dragging or attracting the electrons downwards. And if the electrons get dragged downwards, this chlorine will have a partial positive charge. These chlorines will have a partial, let me correct that. These chlorines are going to have a partial negative charge. Electrons being more electronegative, the hydrogen on the other hand will get a partial positive charge. Now moving to the last molecule, this last molecule is going to be completely nonpolar because on all four sides they are chlorines. So all chlorines are going to try and attract electrons being electronegative. So all these chlorines have a force of attraction on the electrons, trying to pull the electrons towards them. But since the forces of attraction are on opposite sides, the overall force of attraction is going to get cancelled out, which means over here, the overall dipoles, they cancel out. And this would result in the formation of no dipole. All the chlorines are pulling or exerting a force of attraction on opposite side, and that force of attraction would get cancelled out and the electrons would remain evenly distributed in the molecule. So the electrons would not get dragged or would be pulled closer to one of the sides. So option D is going to be the correct option for this question. It's going to have no overall dipole.